an erupting geyser spews out steam. We observe the dramatic transformation of a liquid to a gas. Yet, as chemists, we need to be clear on what we're dealing with. Is something really changing? Or are we just seeing a different arrangement of the same thing? Time to look at this a bit more closely and consider the attractive forces, both in between and within the molecules. This is Real Chem. We will focus on some fundamental principles here. First, let's revisit chemical and physical changes, and then look at inter- and intramolecular forces. These principles and the associated vocabulary are an important part of your toolkit in chemistry. You'll return to them again and again. I remember making flashcards and coming up with mnemonics to remember them. Maybe that could help you too. Vamos a mirar juntos. Let's explore. Let's start by reminding ourselves of the differences between chemical and physical changes. Let's look at the water. When it gets hot, like in a geyser, it changes from a liquid to a gas. But at the end of the day, it's still water. No new substances are formed. It's just a change in state caused by overcoming the intermolecular forces that keep liquid water molecules close to each other. But if we treat water in a different way, like if we pass an electric current through it, we initiate a process called electrolysis, where water forms hydrogen and oxygen gases. By breaking the intramolecular forces that hold water molecules together, this creates new substances. Reactions involve breaking and forming chemical bonds. This is how new substances are formed. For example, when sodium metal, Na, reacts with water, H2O, the intramolecular forces within the water molecules, the OH bonds, and the sodium atoms, metallic bonds, are broken. New substances are formed. Sodium ions, Na+, hydroxide ions, OH-, and hydrogen gas, H2. But what happens when we consider phase changes? That's where intermolecular forces come into play. Intermolecular forces are the attractions between molecules that determine how they behave together. Let's look at water again. When it's cold, the water molecules huddle together, forming a solid structure we call ice. This is because the strong intermolecular forces, like hydrogen bonding, hold them in place. If we add heat, the kinetic energy of the water molecules increases. When the kinetic energy is high enough to partially overcome the intermolecular attractions and the water molecules move from their fixed positions, solid, ice, becomes liquid, water. If we keep heating, there is enough energy to completely overcome the intermolecular forces, and gas, steam, is formed. The strong intermolecular interactions in water lead to high melting and boiling points. Perhaps one of the weakest intermolecular forces are those in helium. Those weak interactions are much easier to overcome. Helium melts and boils at incredibly low temperatures, only about a few degrees above absolute zero. Whenever you see a transformation taking place, whether working in the lab or standing next to a geyser at Yellowstone, think about breaking it down. Ask yourself, what am I seeing here? A change in the intramolecular forces, the intermolecular forces, or both? Pretty soon, you will start to develop a really clear picture of these forces. But also, possibly more importantly, you will start to get used to asking yourself questions that scientists ask all the time. What is going on here? And why? Vamos a explorar. Y no te olvides tener fun.